Welcome to Mecha Facts Episode 8. In today's episode, I'm finally branching out from Gundam and I'll be looking at the VF-171 Nightmare Plus, a mass-production heavy variable fighter from the Macross series. The Nightmare Plus first appeared in the 2008 anime Macross Frontier, then in the movies Macross Frontier, The False Songstress in 2009, and Macross Frontier, The Wings of Goodbye in 2011, and has recently appeared in the 2016 anime Macross Delta. The original mecha designer who designed the Nightmare Plus is Shoji Kawamori. Next is the specifications of the VF-171 Nightmare Plus. Its length in fighter mode is 15.64 meters. Its wingspan is 14.8 meters. Its height in fighter mode is 3.68 meters. Empty mass is 12.15 tons. Standard cruising speed is Mach 3.5+. Max cruising speed is Mach 21+. Max altitude is unlimited as it's capable of leaving atmosphere to outer planetary orbit. Initially powered by two Shinakasu PNW Royce FF2110A thermonuclear turbine engines and is now currently equipped with two Shinakasu PNW Royce FF2550F thermonuclear turbine engines. Its armor structure is a SWAG RA-155 energy conversion armor system, crewed by one pilot. It was developed from the VF-17 Nightmare. The Nightmare Plus was first deployed in 2046 AD and last seen deployed in 2067 AD. Manufactured by General Galaxy, operated by the new United Nations Spacey, the known pilots of the Nightmare Plus is Azima Lee, Jessica Blanc, Hayate Immelman, and Alberto Larrazabal. Next are the armaments and equipment of the Nightmare Plus. First is its pinpoint barrier system. This is an energy shield system that can protect certain parts of the Nightmare Plus when in combat and can be concentrated into the hands in Batroid mode to create an explosive and damaging fist punch. Next is the third generation active stealth system. This stealth system greatly reduces the Nightmare Plus's radar signature from being detected by enemy sensors. Next is the flare and shaft dispenser system. This is a countermeasure system that uses flares as an alternative heat source to force incoming missiles to target these new heat sources of the flares, rather than targeting the Nightmare Plus's heat source being emitted by its thermonuclear engines. Next is one large dorsal-mounted ROTOM and one ventral-mounted antenna. This large ROTOM and antenna are optional equipment designed for cyber warfare, radar, and scanning. It is only used for the early warning and reconnaissance patrol version of the Nightmare Plus, designated as the RVF-171 Nightmare Plus. Next are two Mahler REB-22 beam cannons. This is a pair of forward-facing beam cannons when in fighter mode, located between the wings and the fuselage and below the canopy. Next are the two Aerocon AAB-7B beam cannons. This is a pair of beam cannons mounted on the head of the Nightmare Plus when in Batroid mode and cannot be used in Gurwok and fighter modes. Next is the gun pod, either the Howard GU-14B gun pod or the General Galaxy MC-17C gun pod. The gun pod is a shell-firing, short to mid-range weapon used in Batroid mode. When in fighter mode, the gun pod is mounted on the underside of the Nightmare Plus's airframe. Next is the SSL-9B Dragunov Semi to Fully Automatic Anti-Armor Sniper Rifle. The Dragunov is a mid to long-range electromagnetic railgun equipped with a built-in optical scope and utilizes 55mm ultra-high-speed armor-piercing ammo, used as a sniper rifle when in Batroid mode. Next are two Biforce BML-02S micro-missile launchers. These missile launchers are mounted in the main fuselage near the wing root in the fighter mode and on the top of the shoulders in Batroid mode. Next are six underwing hardpoints. These hardpoints allow for additional armaments such as reaction warheads, air-to-air missiles, 6-2 rocket pods, and triple missile ejector racks for combat. And lastly is the Ordnance Container Loading System. This is located in the engine nacelle units and designed to store additional ordnance and equipment when in combat. Lastly is the history and lore of the Nightmare Plus. The VF-171 Nightmare Plus was one of the main variable fighters of the new UN Spacey that evolved from the VF-17 Nightmare built in the late 2030s. The Nightmare Plus was conceived as the replacement variable fighter for the aging VF-11 Thunderbolt. The Nightmare was designed by General Galaxy originally as a heavy variable fighter for special operations, but the new UN Spacey wished to pursue a mass production model of the Nightmare that would be produced in far greater numbers. Since the Nightmare proved difficult for mass production, the Nightmare was redesigned into the Nightmare Plus in the mid-2040s as a comparatively downgraded model that's a more cost-effective option to procure. effectively a lesser version of the Nightmare, the Nightmare Plus was modified to enhance its maneuverability and extend its service life. In building the Nightmare Plus, the most noticeable changes were made to extend the nose and enlarge the cockpit canopy for a superior field of view. The engine leg units were redesigned, along with the main wings, fuselage, and arms for improved aerodynamics. Lastly, the defenses of the Nightmare Plus was strengthened and featured a pinpoint barrier system which wasn't equipped in the previous model. The Nightmare Plus's improvement of control, which was the flaw of the original Nightmare, and an update of the control system avionics greatly reduced the burden on its pilot, so that it became an airframe that treated average pilots well when in operation. With a variety of hardware available, the Nightmare Plus, with its low cost and versatility, became the standard variable fighter of the new UN Spacey for over 20 years. Prior to the events of Macross Frontier, SMS pilot Ozma Lee had piloted a Nightmare Plus for the new UN Spacey, where he was assigned to defend the STFN-4 Global and its research fleet in 2048. Another character, Jessica Blanc, the sister of Michael Blanc, had also piloted a Nightmare Plus for the new UN Spacey assigned to the Macross Frontier and its emigrant fleet, where Jessica's unit in particular would use the Dragunov sniper rifle. In 2059, the Nightmare Plus would be the frontline variable fighter of the new UN Spacey and would see heavy action during the Badger War. Hundreds of Nightmare Plus units were stationed at the Macross Frontier's emigrant fleet, with many being deployed to defend the fleet from Badger incursions, the rescue operation of the Macross Galaxy's emigrant fleet, and the final battle over the Badger's homeworld. When the war prolonged itself, the new UN Spacey of the Macross Frontier would upgrade the current models of the Nightmare Plus with the newest anti-Vajra technology to provide it with a fighting edge over the Vajra, thus creating the VF-171EX Nightmare Plus, an improved variant of the standard Nightmare Plus mainly used to fight the Vajra. However, I will not be discussing the VF-171EX in this episode, so you'll have to see it in a different episode of Mecha Facts. Luckily, I will be telling you about another variant that does exist for the Nightmare Plus, which is an early warning and reconnaissance patrol unit for the new UN Spacey, designated as the RVF-171 Nightmare Plus. This variant is equipped with a large ROTAM and ventral antenna to provide cyber warfare and radar systems for reconnaissance. Along with these added features, the reconnaissance variant of the Nightmare Plus can still be mounted with its original complement of armaments like missiles and rockets to engage in combat if needed. The French's fleet is seen deploying multiple RVF-171 Nightmare Pluses throughout the Vajra War to at least give the Frontier an early warning edge when being attacked by the Vajra, and would also use these units to recon areas ahead of the French's fleet before it arrives. Here's a fun fact. According to Shoji Kawamori, the director of Macross Frontier, the VF-171 Nightmare Plus was chosen as the main variable fighter for the setting of Macross Frontier, because the previously designed UN Spacey variable fighter, the VF-19 Excalibur, appeared too much like a hero unit, as Kawamori desired a grunt variable fighter that was clearly distinguishable from the hero unit of this series, the VF-25 Messiah. In 2067, 8 years following the events of Macross Frontier, the Nightmare Plus is still the main variable fighter of the new UN Spacey during the events of Macross Delta. The unit stationed in the Mazinger Globular Cluster would feature a new tan color scheme than the blue color scheme seen in Macross Frontier. The Nightmare Plus would see heavy action as the new UN Spacey would go to war with the Kingdom of Windmere. From fighting against allies infected with the VAR syndrome to the direct combat with Windmere's military and their infamous Aeronites, the Nightmare Plus would be one of the main variable fighters used by the new UN Spacey as they fought for control over the cluster. With main character of Macross Delta, Hayate Immelman seen piloting, or more like dancing around in a Nightmare Plus during a VAR syndrome outbreak on the planet Al-Shahal. Later, Commander Alberto Larrazabal also pilots a Nightmare Plus for the new UN Spacey Forces station on the planet Voldor. However, during the events of Macross Delta, he's also infected with the VAR syndrome and was controlled by Windmere's military until he broke free from the control thanks to the powerful singing of the tactical sound group Walkure. Here's another fun fact. The VF-171 Nightmare Plus and its predecessor, the VF-17 Nightmare, took design inspirations and features found in the real-world F-117 Nighthawk, a stealth attack fighter used by the United States Air Force. This fighter has long been since retired from active service since 2008. This wraps up Episode 8 of Mecha Facts on the VF-171 Nightmare Plus. So if you enjoyed the episode, please click that subscribe button below along with that notification bell to stay up to date on future episodes. Also, if you liked the video, click that thumbs up below, and if you have any comments of how I can improve my content or tell me some lore that I did not know about the Nightmare Plus, please comment them below. Thanks for watching Mecha Facts, and I'll see you guys next time.